So I'm Sean, if you don't know me. I think most people watching this probably do. I thought just as a little change, just to do something a little bit different, I'll do this blog as a video log or vlog or whatever you call it. So here we are. This is going to be about this Friday just gone. A couple of things happened. But the main thing really was that it made things real for the first time. It's like that moment, that holy shit moment, this is actually happening. What are we about? 1 minute in already. So yeah, this is about Friday. This is about that holy shit moment. This is about that moment when you realise this is actually happening. And you know, I thought I'd sort of come to terms with it. I mean, you can never really come to terms with that news, I don't think. But I've had a couple of weeks since we were told the diagnosis. It's a good while to sink in, you know. You can tell people without getting upset, you know, you sort of become numb to that side of things, and you just sort of get used to the idea that, you know, this is what's happening, this is going to be it now. Constant medication, you know, people fussing over you all the time, and yeah, that's just life now, and you become used to it. But up until this Friday, all the treatment I've had on the medication, it's been purely for treating the pain and, you know, basically morphine drugging me up, and then treating the side effects of that morphine, which are not pleasant. But I've not actually had any treatment for the actual cancer. So that's what Friday was about. Wednesday and Friday. Wednesday I went in and had a scan. I've done a full blog post on this, so I'll link to it below this video, so you can go read that if you haven't already. So just briefly, Wednesday I had a scan done. I think they call it a marking up scan. And then on Friday I had my first treatment. Also on Friday we had a Macmillan nurse come visit us Friday morning. And he was really good. I think it's called Giles. And he was really good. He went over loads of different things. His sort of primary purpose is to help with pain management and make sure we're on top of things in that sense. He went away and made a phone call and increased my dosage of Oromorph, for example, which is a big help actually. So that's his primary purpose. He also went over a couple of other things. One of the questions he asked was, where would I like to be when I die? I wasn't expecting that question at all. I was completely unprepared. It just threw me a bit. It's not something you ever really think about. I answered home. I want to be at home, and there's no doubt in my mind about that. And he started going on about the other options, which was firstly hospital, which is not pleasant. I don't think anybody would choose that unless you're maybe elderly or something, or you can't take care of yourself. Second option was hospice. Again, I don't know, maybe more elderly. Maybe you need a bit more support, I don't know. There's an option sort of using the hospice intermittently, I suppose you could say, just going in as and when I need it and spending a bit of time there, having a break to sort of rest and then coming back home. But yeah, I decided that I wanted to die at home, and I don't see can't see any other option being just an option at all for me. I would want to be at home with my family, with my daughter, with my wife. So there is no other option. That's the way it has to be. A little bit of concern about space. They were saying they'd have to, what would be ideal really, to bring in sort of a hospital style bed. You can adjust the bed so you can get comfy and stuff. Which again got me thinking about, shit, how bad am I going to get? You know, I never really thought that far down the line. You know, how painful is this going to get? How uncomfortable am I going to be? That I'm going to need specialised equipment and, you know, a hospital bed in my front room. You know, it's... I'm going to have to be in a pretty bad state to need that. So that's quite a scary thought. And it was offering me a wheelchair as well, and it's straight away, no, I'm not having a wheelchair. I want to keep out and about, keep moving, stay independent, I guess you could say. I don't want to rely on somebody pushing me around in a wheelchair. That's... Now, from where I've come from, how old I am, I don't know. It's about 6 months from now that might completely change and I'll be begging for a wheelchair, I'll be begging for a specialised bed, who knows. But right now, the way I'm feeling now, it's no, definitely not. I mean, it fucking hurts, really fucking hurts, especially after the treatment that I've had. I covered it a little bit in my latest blog post, I think, went live the other day. Again, I'll link to that below. But it's, I had my treatment, pain's been getting worse ever since I had radiotherapy on my pelvis. My right leg has swollen. It hurts to walk. I've got almost a permanent limp on the go right now. It's just at times I seem to completely seize up and it's just constant pain and not sleeping, and you can probably tell by the red rings around my eyes, and it's a nightmare at the minute. And the painkillers are helping quite a lot, but anyway, I'm going off on a tangent. So yeah, that was the story of the day, this Macmillan nurse. Where do you want to die? Yeah, thanks for throwing that at me. Then that afternoon I had the first treatment, and we were sat in the car. It was over in Leeds, St James's Hospital, I forget the name of the ward, and we sat in the car, we're driving over, and it just suddenly came over me, like, this is actual treatment for cancer. And it hit me again, that first moment when I was first told what it was. You just say, yeah, okay, cancer hits you hard, but you can sort of handle it. But then it hit me again, driving over. It's like, oh shit, I've actually got cancer. They're treating me for cancer. It's made it very real. Sorry, being a complete pansy. I never really saw it that way before. I mean, I knew what it was, obviously, but I didn't really see it as that. I started thinking about all the things I'm going to miss. and Miss Madara grown up. It's slightly selfish, but I'm not going to see her grow up, I'm not going to see her. I'm not going to see her be a successful woman. I know she's going to be. I'm going to miss out on so much of her life. And it's going to completely crush her. When it does finally happen, it's going to crush her. We're so close. Jesus. I'm thinking that this Christmas coming could be the last Christmas I spend with them, with my wife and my daughter. Hopefully not, hopefully I'll live longer than that, I'll live longer than the estimate. But it could be the last one. It could be my last birthday, it could be Freya's last birthday. Could be my wife's last birthday. Could be the last of so much. I try not to think like that. I try to think it's only an estimate. I could very well outlive that. Doctors could be completely wrong. I could beat it even, you know? I don't know. Realistically, probably not, but, you know, I like to be realistic, but. A bit of hope never hurt anyone, yeah. So yeah, last Friday, that's the day it became very real for me. I think things have settled down again since, you know, you go back to the routine and you get used to it again, you become numb to it again. I'll probably be out now until the next thing happens, which is going to be the start of the medical trial. Hopefully I've got to have some tests done to see if I'm eligible for the trial. I've forgotten the name of the drug, but it's a immunotherapy trial. Yeah, I can't think of the name of the actual drug at the minute, but it's supposed to be quite effective. So that could be quite good. So I need to have some tests done. I'm waiting for test dates to come through for that. And hopefully I'll be eligible and I can start treatment. So yeah, I might do a blog post in a bit more detail on the trial and what it entails and what the drug is. I don't know. I might do that. I might. We'll see. But yeah, I suppose for now that's it. That's all I wanted to say. If you made it to the end of the video, well done. And I don't know. Let me know if you want to see more of this kind, I suppose. It's better than words on a screen, I think. It means more. I don't know. I'm being a soppy git right now. But yeah, thank you. Thank you for listening. If you have watched the whole thing, thank you.